Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, the Christmas is at hand. The Lord is coming to dwell within us with a lot of blessings. The Gospel according to Luke chapter 1, towards the end, writes the Canticle of Zechariah. He notices the wonders, the blessings God has done in the history of Israel and also to him and his family, and he praises and thanks God. Dear friends, I remember a family, a father, a mother, and two children. One day, the mother prepared a very delicious recipe. They all enjoyed the meal. And they just left like that. But the father, as a piece of advice, asked the second son, "Why don't you thank your mother? You know, she spent a lot of time for this delicious food preparation." But immediately the second son, replied saying, "Why should I thank her? This is her duty, right?" Dear friends, sometimes we fail to notice the kindness of others in our life and we just live like that. But here, the second son, his own words struck him and he started noticing each and everything his mother was doing for him, and he remained grateful to her forever. St. Paul, in his first letter to the Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 18, highlights the gratefulness as one of the qualities of the Christian vocation. The scripture proclaims this virtue, that is being grateful, as the will of God for each one of us. From the moment we start our day, we find many people being an inspiration for us. Many people helping us in various places, in various situations, and even taking risk on our behalf. Some are even sacrificing their time to make us happy. But we just take these things for granted, and we just live like that and move to the next day without noticing any of these acts of kindness. And it is here, dear brothers, dear sisters, Zechariah is exhorting each one of us, first of all, to notice the blessings that we receive in our daily life, and then to be thankful for each of them, be it an act of charity from our own parents or our own companions, sometimes an act of generosity from the colleagues in the office or the places where we work. Let us not leave those situations without expressing our sentiments of gratitude. Along with Zechariah in the Gospel, let us thank God for all the blessings that we receive. And may this Christmas help each one of us to sing the song of thanksgiving to God for sending forth His Son for us, for redeeming us from the clutches of sin, for blessing us with a good living situation, and gifting us the near and dear ones. May God bless each one of us. Praise be Jesus.